Hi everyone, and welcome to another reverse engineering episode. In this video, we'll reverse a Crackme exercise using x64dbg and Snowman decompiler. We crafted a short program that asks for a password, performs some internal checks, and then displays a success or error message. Open the file in x64dbg and let's analyze the code. The first step is in NTDLL, but we're not interested in this one. So we'll hit run and reach the main entry point. Let's see if we can match the assembly code with what we're seeing in the console output. For this, we will search for all the strings referenced in the current module. Right-click and then select Find References. Here they are, all the messages we've seen before. Take any of them and follow it in the disassembler. Based on the messages, notice this is the actual function that verifies the password. Set a breakpoint and run until it is being hit. The first message is about to be printed in the next function. To better understand the code, we'll download and install Snowman, the compiler plugin. Snowman is open source and available as a standalone application or plugin for either Pro and x64dbg. There are already compiled plugin versions for both 32 and 64-bit architectures. We need to download the corresponding files and place them into the corresponding folders. I've already done that to save some time and focus now on more interesting things. One way to use this plugin is to right-click, choose Snowman, and then the compile selection. Select some lines of assembly code and then use the decompile selection option. We got actual source code now, which is nice. We see error messages, functions, and so on. Still, there is a big chunk of code that doesn't make too much sense. Here's a useful trick. Before decompiling, we need to reanalyze the module. Now, there will be a new option under Snowman menu, the compile function. As we'll see, this gets much cleaner code. The code looks different. We have all the messages we were expecting. Here's a possible comparison for the flag, and two possible branches depending on the correctness of the flag. Also an interesting loop here that probably verifies the entered password. Let's start by making sense of these functions, since the code is quite short. This function looks like a scanf that will read 10 characters from standard input. We can rename functions in this decompiler window for convenience. This one over here prints something. This one compares to strings, very probably used to check the validity of our input. Rename it as well. What is left is we have to make sense of the while loop. We could change the execution flow to reach the correct branch corresponding to the correct flag. But we don't want to do this in this episode. We actually want to reverse engineer the flag generation logic. It's more important to become comfortable with analyzing assembly code. This address over here is a place where our input will be stored. It should be empty at the moment. We stopped at a breakpoint before this line. Let's check what it contains in a hex dump view. it contains only zeros. It's empty now. V1 here is an index that goes from 0 to 9, and for each character of the input flag, it will perform some operation. For each character, the code subtracts the number 48, which is hex 30, and represents the ASCII code for number 0. The meaning of this line is simple. Each character must be an ASCII number represented as char, and subtracting 48 will result in its integer value. This is a very nice and useful trick to obtain the numerical value of an ASCII character. So this first condition here makes sure that each of the 10 characters in the flag is a digit from 0 to 9. Notice another interesting address here that seems to be used in the validation process. We'll check it in a moment. Copy the address from here and let's go to a hex view to see what we have here. Press Ctrl-G to bring up the jump window and paste the address of the memory location. Look at these numbers. They are addresses in little endian order. Go 4 bytes back and notice that we have something that looks like a list of structures. We have an ASCII character represented on 4 bytes, followed by a pointer on the next 4 bytes, and so on. Each element of this list is 8 bytes in size. Take a moment to look at this hex dump. The pattern will be important later. Maybe you've noticed that this is not exactly a linked list, since there are pairs of elements here that link to each other. What matters now is to see that each 8 bytes node from this list contains a letter and a link to another similar structure. Related to the nodes, in this assignment instruction we have a double pointer. For each node, we will navigate to another one using the pointer, and then obtain the ASCII character stored in the adjacent node. Let's recap the logic. In a loop, we'll get the letter value of the node referenced by the current node from 0 to 9. The value is then copied into another buffer location, this one here, ending in FAC. At the end of the while routine, we are expecting to find a specific value in that buffer. So this plain string is not the actual flag. That's the comparison we're interested in. Spoiler alert! Here is the full flag computed based on this logic. Stop if you want to try it yourself. I really encourage you to practice retrieving the full flag by yourself. Okay, one last point. Let's do a spot check and see again how we came up with those numbers. The address of the node element containing 8 ends in 10. This is linked in the element at address ending in 40, which has the character number 8 and is at index 6 in the list. That's exactly what we've seen in the spoiler. The first character of the flag is 6, which is the index of the node containing 8. Doing this for all the characters in the string being compared, we will obtain the full flag. Let's see if we were right in our analysis. Test the flag with the sample. Great! So far so good, but we're not actually done yet. In the next video, we'll see a more interesting trick to obtain the flag by doing instrumented symbolic execution. Make sure to master the reverse engineering first, since we will use extracted information in the next part. Although this was a simple exercise, the analysis pattern will be the same for more complicated ones. Stay tuned for more exercises. Thank you very much. If you like this, please subscribe. It will help this channel to be discovered. See you soon!